So the discus is coming off of this finger. That's no good. And we're gonna talk about why and how to fix it in this video. So check it out. Everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Air Today Throws Nation, and in today's video, we are going to answer a question that a lot of you ask, and that is, why is my discus coming off the middle finger? What does that mean? What's the middle finger for? We always talk about this. It's not meant for throwing. It's meant for something that's not very polite and makes people angry. So you want to avoid it at all costs because it's going to impact your discus in a negative way as well. So one of the questions we received was, why is it that I can do my stand throw? So when you see me throw here and we wind back and I'm gonna get that off my middle finger, what happens? And if I'm doing a half turn throw, if I'm gonna be here and I'm coming through and I'm gonna throw it this way, why is it that on those I can throw? So this is our pillar 5-6 and pillar 3-4-5-6 in our chain reaction system. When I add pillar 1-2, why is it that now the discus is coming off of the middle finger? Good question. And one of the basics is when we're in the stand throw, when you guys are learning to stand now, whether you do it right or wrong, we just gonna put the discus in this position and it's easy to keep the discus back. When we're starting to add pillar 1 and 2 to our full throw, we're changing how the arm's carried. So what happens is we talk about how the thumb angle changes on the discus and we start to see the hand pointing like this. And when we're doing stand throws, it's easy to drag the discus here. What happens is when we start to add pillar 1 and 2, so when we get back to this position or we go to a full throw or we go to our South African drills or we're doing any of this type of movement, this is where people run into problems on keeping the discus back. So we see this is a big problem with quite a few people. And what is typically happening is that carry position that you will do easier on your stand throw, again, pillar 5-6 or your half turn modified wheels, we call them, will be your pillar 3-4, right? We're moving 3-4-5-6. It's easier. You're starting basically with that arm back. In the full throw, you would think keeping it back, but you've got to open up. And what happens is people start to get uncomfortable and they're carrying the discus. And now the hand is sitting like this. So the thumb and hand goes from here. So you see this line to here. So one of the things that you want to understand is that now why that changes and why it starts to come off the middle finger is because when I get to the full throw and I start to carry the discus or I turn the discus over, the orbit and the shoulder, you're starting to throw yourself off balance. You're going to wind up turning the hand and you're going to have the discus like this and no longer stretched like this. And we want to see that hand and thumb in this position so that the discus is coming off of this index finger. Now, the faster you spin the discus, the longer it stays in the air. This is something you need to learn and develop. And many beginning throwers don't really adequately know how to spin the discus. So buying a big expensive rim weight disc, some $400 disc, when you don't have the skill set to maximize that is not necessarily the most advantageous thing. Now, whether you have a low rim weight disc or a high rim weight disc, if you know how to spin the discus, the distance is gonna be relatively close, but the key is if you don't, the distance is gonna be significantly different because you can't adequately spin the heavy rim weight disc. Now, why again is it coming off of the middle finger? One of the things we'd recommend, we posted a video called How to Add 20 Feet to Your Throw, talking about the grip and release in the discus, and you can go back and check that. But what we're kind of reiterating is specifically, why is it always coming off the middle finger? And that is gonna be, you're gonna be having to see something in your carry position. So we've worked with a number of athletes. Again, the biggest point, what you wanna understand is what you need to be working on is how to release the discus. So doing some more walkthroughs and drills and static throws are gonna be some simple things you can do. So we like to do some basic drills where we're gonna be here, and now that's gonna teach you how to move and keep the discus back, and that's gonna set up that better hand position, which is gonna change. Now, some people say, well, I have a really long middle finger, and some people do, but even if it's that long, it's still a matter of how you are angling the hand, and now you're able to still have the index finger is primarily what's on the rim of the discus, and it's going to be able to snap and spin far. So quick simple tip today, if you guys are having a hard time and that discus is coming off your middle finger and you know that is not what it's supposed to do because that middle finger shouldn't be used for anything but grabbing things. So You want to make sure that it's coming off of this finger. You got to play and realize that it's really what it's coming in is how you're carrying the discus. That has a huge impact. That's going to affect your orbit and your radius and the amount of power and your balance typically throughout the throw. So this is a simple fix, but it takes a few weeks. Be patient. You might have a bunch of crappy throws, but you have to realize that something you're doing in your throw, at some point you're getting that hand position from here to here, and now that's what's going to wind up having your hand, your main finger come off. You're shortening your radius, and you're likely turning the discus up. It's coming off the middle finger, and you're gonna lose a lot of distance. And none of us wanna do that. All right, guys, so hopefully that is a helpful tip. Thanks so much for watching. Hit that subscribe button. Comment below on other things you'd like to see, and we will see you on the next video.